For those stations not taking a pledge break, the NewsHour continues now with a story from a new project we call NewsHour Connect. That's where we showcase the best of public broadcasting from around the country. Tonight, from a collaboration of Maine, New Hampshire, and Vermont PBS stations, a report on a community-based effort to help the local fishing industry survive. The reporter is Phil Vaughn.
At Hampton Harbor Marina, not far from the open Atlantic, sits the Ellen Diane. Her captain is David Gaethel.
I started fishing in 1967, working as crew on a party boat in Seabrook, Eastman's.
For nearly 30 years, the Ellen Diane has carried Gaethel and his crew to sea. They fish for a living.
It's never the same 2 days in a row. The fish got tails, they know how to use them. And despite all the electronics in this wheelhouse, that stuff doesn't find anything. It's still the guy who drives the boat that actually finds the fish. So I like the challenge. I like the mental challenge.
And that's a good thing. New England's fishing industry is facing a boatload of challenges. The cost of getting to the fish is going up, the market is shrinking, and new regulations reduce the size of the catch.
What has that done for livelihoods?
Well, in New Hampshire, it's put about 50% of the boats out of business. And the other 50% that are left are facing a very uncertain future.
But the men and women who make a living on the water know how to survive. 10 years ago in New Hampshire, they created Yankee Fishermen's Co-op.
Any product that gets sold through here that makes money puts money in their pocket.
Bob Campbell manages the co-op. Members bring their catch to him where it's documented. A portion goes to restaurants and stores, which eliminates the middleman, the distributor, who normally takes a percentage of the profits. This year, Yankee Co-op and its 62 members are trying something new for New Hampshire. A community-supported fisheries known as CSF.
This was our first year to do a community-supported fisheries for our native shrimp. The native shrimp market over the past few years has been very limited, and we've been trying to work out a way where we could get direct to consumer.
The co-op produces small quantities of shrimp for people who agree to buy a certain amount over a period of time in increments of 5 or 10 pounds.
New Hampshire fishermen switched to the CSF direct marketing model to retain more profits from an increasingly difficult livelihood.
People in North Carolina, the fishing industry, began looking at this kind of mode of selling, which is very innovative for the fishing industry. And then this group in Maine said, hey, you know, this could work. We might be able to do it here.
Ken LaValle is a commercial fisheries specialist at the University of New Hampshire. He says there are real economic benefits with community-supported fisheries.
For the shrimp industry and for the Yankee Fishermen's Co-op, this year fishermen may have been getting about 50 cents a pound in its first year, but they sold probably 10,000 pounds of shrimp that they wouldn't have otherwise sold. And they sold it at $1.60 a pound instead of 51 cents a pound.
And LaValle says there's another benefit. One that fishermen are now getting used to.
Yes, it's a recession. It's important that fishermen are now finding innovative ways to make more money to maintain themselves in this livelihood. Can you imagine New England without a fishing community? I can't. So it's great that fishermen are now thinking this way. But there's a social aspect too.
It's developing a relationship between local consumers and fishermen.
Here, you know, they caught it today. They just took it out of the water. It's as fresh as you can get.
And you get to meet the fishermen, right?
Yeah.
Do you like the model? Does it work?
Yeah, I like the model. I wish we could get more people involved. So we need about 10 times the interest in the CSF that we have right now.
You can see all of the story on community fishing on our website, newshour.pbs.org.